While in the caverns, Pontius had picked up some mushrooms, but Zoya and Amadeus persuaded him not to eat them. Amadeus recalled a time when he had made a mushroom potion in his school days. Indeed, that had not ended well. As the heroes climbed out of the caverns, they met with the first light of morning.
A beautiful dawn.
Rosabelle's castle shouldn't be far now.
There's some huge hairy fruit up in those trees.
They're called coconuts.
So there's some huge hairy nuts?
No, they're fruit.
Shouldn't they be called cocoa fruit, then?
I don't know.
Thank you.
Is this quite safe?
My sister is sweet, while I am unseen. But she is not strong. I should be queen.
This is going to require timing.
Dreadful weather! birthday celebrations were lavish. Sadly, they were disrupted by Princess Rosabelle, who felt she had been slighted by her gifts. Princess Isabel received a golden gown, a diamond tiara, and a pair of silk gloves. Princess Rosabelle received a silver gown, a moonstone necklace, and a pair of lace gloves.
Did you know that the octopus has three hearts?
Hey, that's just like us. Thank you, Mr. Octopus. Lady Rosabelle.
Well, well, she wasn't lying about being queen.
Zoya, a noble lady like her wouldn't tell lies.
Action! last. I'll keep his crown if you don't mind.
Hurrah! We've cleared the halls for Her Majesty!
And our own kingdom will soon be safe. Shall we head back to the house?
Not so quick. I want to take a look around first.
Oh, must we?
Look, this is Isabel. It's got her name on it.
Yes, Rosabelle's sister. The one who used to own the portal locket.
So where is she now?
Dear Isabel, happy 18th. Congratulations also for becoming the crown princess and heir to the throne. To celebrate, I have a surprise in the cellars. It's a big secret. Tell no one. Go through the laundry room. I'll meet you there, Rosabelle.
The artifact of souls. It's imbued with great power. I could use it to bring you back and restore the kingdom.
Come on, let's follow it.